Welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to assume an IAM role from the Management Console. I'm logged into my account and I'm on the dashboard of the Identity and Access Management Console. We're going to create a new user. So I'm going to go to Users, click Add Users, and I'm going to call my user Paul. I'm only going to provide Management Console access for Paul at this point in time. I'm going to configure my own password, and I'm going to remove the requirement to reset the password. Then we can click Next to go to Permissions, and I'm not going to provide any permissions to Paul at this point in time. Let's click on Next, Review. It's going to warn me that, of course, Paul doesn't have any permissions, so he's not going to be able to do anything. Now, Paul will be able to log into the console, but then won't be able to do anything. Now, let's just create this user. So the user's been created, and what we're going to do is go back to the main console, so click on Close. Now, back on the Users pane here, I'm going to select Paul, and what I want to do is I need Paul's ARN, so the Amazon resource name, so I'm going to click Copy here to copy that to my clipboard. Now, you'll find a file in the course download, which you can download from the last lesson in section one. And in there, once you've unzipped the course download, you'll find a code directory, IAM, and then you'll find this switch role trust policy.json. Now, what I want to do in here is I need to enter the ARN for Paul between these two inverted commas here. So I'm just going to paste in Paul's ARN. And then I can copy all of this code to my clipboard. Now, this is the trust policy for the role. Back in IAM, let's go to roles, and we're going to create the IAM role that Paul is going to assume. So let's choose create role. I'm going to choose custom trust policy, and then I'm going to delete the code in here and paste in the code that we just updated. So now we have a trust policy, and this trust policy is going to allow the principal, and it's configured specifically for Paul to assume a role. So it's allowing Paul the privilege to be able to assume an IAM role. Then we click on Next, and I'm going to search for EC2. So let's just search for EC2 in the top here, and I'm going to select the Amazon EC2 full access. So this IAM role is going to be assumable by Paul. Paul will be allowed to assume this role. And then when Paul assumes this role, he will have the EC2 full access permissions. So let's click on Next, give it a name. I'm going to call it EC2-full-access. And then let's just scroll down and create that role. So the role's been created. All we need to do now is log in as Paul, and we're going to see if we can assume this role. I'm now logged in as Paul in a private window, so I've still got my Management Console logged in as myself, and then in a private window, I'm logged in as Paul. So if I now go over to the EC2 Management Console, what we should see is these API errors, and that's because Paul doesn't have any permissions. So essentially it's saying you don't have any permissions to view any of the information in EC2, and he wouldn't be able to launch instances or do anything in EC2. So what we want to do is assume a role so that we can then get those permissions through the IAM role that we created previously. Now, back in the console where I'm logged in as myself, I'm logged in as Neil, I'm just going to go into this role. So let's click on the role. And what you'll find is all the information you need to assume the role is actually provided here. There's even a link that you can use to do it for you. Now, all we really need is the account number of the account and the name of the role. So what I'm going to do is the easiest place to find the account number is you just come back up to the dashboard, click on copy, and I've got that on my clipboard. Now, logged back in as Paul here, I'm going to go up into the top right hand corner, choose switch role, click switch role again. I'm going to paste in my account number. I need to put in the name of the role, and then I can add a display name as well. Once I've entered that information, I can choose switch role. And I've now switched roles, and as you can see, all those API errors have gone. So we can now actually use EC2. So what we've done is we've logged in as Paul. Paul was unable to do anything in EC2 because he doesn't have any permissions. But the permission that we did assign was for Paul to be able to assume a role. And once he assumed that role, he had access to whatever the permissions assigned to that role are. In this case, that's EC2 full access. So now Paul is free to do whatever he wants in EC2 and can always then switch back by just clicking on switch back. And then he'll go back to being logged in purely as Paul. And of course, all the API errors return because Paul no longer has those permissions. So that's how you assume a role using the AWS Management Console.